to play, and right now it's South Africa and Fiji squaring off in the cup final. A great take from the kickoff from Fiji, and Katoni Bau comes hearing through after it, knocks on.
Bit of nerves there from this Fijian team straight off the bat. It was a nice lift and catch by Osea Kuminisau, the captain. He tried to hit Katoni Bau on the fly. Would have been tough to stop as well. So this is a huge settler for the South African team. But they're big boys, other ones that really stood up. And in particular, Chris Dry, on the other side of the screen, jersey number one. He has been outstanding all tournament long.
Right. Bang. Set.
A chance here for South Africa with Cecil Africa to feed the scrum. Fiji King for going early, and they come on quickly. South Africa. Really chunk from the political slide across the field. Ball. So he's wide for the ball's out in front and into touch.
Moves on both sides, isn't it really? Branko Dupree usually hits Soyswapi every day of the week. On that occasion, he just pushed the pass a little bit of jitters there. Soyswapi open space as well. That is a big miss here. Branko Dupree gets on the outside of his play, creates a 2-on-1. Osea Kuminisau is actually beaten on the outside too.
Get out of jail on that occasion. Up and loose pass with G. Second touch of the ball, they peel to the short side for Katoni Bau. And that's a sockle on the side forward, the player looking at Axel. And here comes one of the best, getting around Turai looking to link up there. Can't do so, and another little bobble at the base of the ruck against Fiji.
Gina Turai fell very heavily in that tackle. Good makeup run by Cecil Africa. Look like just twisted his leg in the process. He's a guy that can spark something from other. Those two guys have gone at it over a number of times. Cecil Africa and Jerry Tua.
And to
line
it quicker,
keep it up. He's sort of four tries this weekend for his side, and seemingly with every single touch, he either creates or scores himself.
There's a guy for the big stage, Jerry Tua. They can ill afford to lose him this early. Tom Bell, I think he's been outstanding as a leader for the Fijian four-pack since he's been introduced back into this tournament.
Here he is, Gareth Faber, the boss for Fiji. He's concerned as well, he might be, as we mentioned, Jerry Tua among the top five players on the circuit. He's just lethal.
He
likes the big stage, that's where he stands up, and that's the mark of a great player. Good players want the ball in their hands on the bigger stage at the right moment. He's definitely one of those.
Yep.
Little nerves creeping into both sides, and we're going to just pack it down again.
This is the bat I'm really interested in. Two full backs. Dylan Sage was outstanding on this near side as well. He's smiling as he's going against Katoni Bau in that semi-final.
Set. Good. Ball in.
Dupree gets it in, slaps it back for Africa. Oh, and he's called there, Africa, but on the break goes Kopp. Important tackle made by Tuai there. This is Sage. Sage, an oval pass across to Snyman, the captain. And he's hit hard there by Kunavula. Dupree goes from across the park. Kopp fires it wide. This time around, Soyswapi brings it in. Soyswapi. 20 from the Fijian line. Dupree now. The crossfield kick is a call from Dry out wide. Dupree goes through the middle. Kuminisau makes the steal and pulls away with it. Kuminisau. They give chase. Kuminisau's right lining it. Needs help. Gets it from Nasoko. Nasoko looking for help. Katoni Bau gets there in the nick of time. Chasing first points here, Fiji, and they're going to get them. Nothing a thumb. Fiji hit first.
This Fijian team is starting to fire on all cylinders at the right time. Kuminisau breaks right up the middle of the park. And look at this pass by his time. Draws in two defenders. Did extremely well. Nice step as well from Nasoko. Lets the ball go, releases. Buys time to see Katoni Bau in the background. Just telling him to go down, reset. Look at the numbers there. Hunting and Pax of the Fijians, and Mothel Nathangi gets the start. He gets the first try for Fiji.
And that work of the breakdown from Colin Isao as well. He pounced and shot away with it. Vovo from out wide. So it's top try scorer here in Hong Kong this weekend. Conversion is on its way and misses the target. So the score stays Fiji 5 with South Africa yet to post points. Gee, that was a frenetic run of play, Carl Tanana.
South Africa actually had all the momentum. They went halfway through a hole and then, as you said, the turnover from the captain, that's where they're so lethal. They're picking when to challenge at the breakdown and when not to, Fiji.
Revolvo gets it up, looking for Gatoni Bao. Good is the call. Colin Isao pops up. Revolvo. Another chance here for Fiji. Kudabula looks for a socket on the switch. And turn goes to Revolvo. Clears it back for Kudabula. Kudabula getting through the line. Kudabula, unstoppable.
Seeing some Fijian flair. The offloads, the distribution, the pre-line attack, you see that? Man, they're just so composed at the moment, are the Fijians. And look at this power from the young man, Kunavola. Gets the second one.
Revolvo looking to make it a 12-point game. It's tugged away to the left. Fijian fans are happy for the moment. This side up by 10. Just exploded onto the scene this year. Prolific try scorer and just a monster for the 23-year-old.
He's taken over from Kunitani, who left the squad, and then you get a guy like Kunavula step into his shoes. Brilliant.
Pop gets it right this time. There's a bound there to Pop for the immediate reply here. South Africa. Dry. Soccer goes low and hangs on. All good. Waiting to make an attack is often funny. Now the ball against the Fijians. Cock goes on quickly. Shoots it to the right. Fiji offside then. Continue about race up too quickly out wide. Now Swizwapa.
Rock!
He's on the ground for Africa. Africa. Well, that's a good tackle from Revolvo. They pile in. It's just a mess of bodies. But it is the Fijians who are penalised.
Well, they're bullying the bully at the moment, these Fijians. They're matching the physicality that usually the South Africans bring. They just need to settle down here. A couple of loose passes, uncharacteristic.
You okay?
For the blitz bot.
Time on.
I don't know how the Kuri's come out of that unscathed. Two miles away, a buck 05 on top. It's like WrestleMania for a moment.
It's a tough kick bump from the Bria. Set for the tap kick here short.
What can they get happening here? The Blitzbocker down by 10. Terrific ball out in front for Sage. But the cover defence is up to the task. They rumble them into touch. And at halftime, it is Fiji up by 10 over South Africa. Last year. And they've got a good vibe going now as Revolvo gets just restarted. Katoni Bao slaps it back. It's going to fall the way of Fiji. Knock on the call against the Blitzbocker.
Yeah, that's been the mismatch Fiji have been looking for. Katoni Bao against Werner Kok. Werner Kok, the smaller man. Katoni Bao just getting up and competing in that area. And they've won three, I think, in fact.
Nothing before the ball.
South Africa need to change their lineup, need to get someone on Werner Kok. For me, the big men for South Africa, they really haven't imposed themselves yet, whereas Fiji have.
Set.
Some handy field position for Fiji to work with here as well. That's scrappy at the back. Somehow it's going to come back here for Sage. Africa across to Dupria. Links with Kok, who looks up, drops it cold. That is very unlike Werner Kok.
All the pressure on Sunday. Here in Hong Kong, 45,000 looking down on you. He has done everything so well over the weekend. He just had a little look where he was going before he secured the ball. One of the best in the business, Werner Kock, on both sides of the ball.
Carlton Arnott, you have called each of Fiji's cup losses this series. Did you get a sense there's a different vibe in that halftime huddle though?
Most definitely, Sean. You can see they were really on to it. You can see they were engaged, they were listening, they were talking. And that's the thing for me, the communication. I think this is what this guy has brought on screen. Asake Katoni Bao, a calming influence on this Fijian side for sure.
Jussa Vermaelu, another added to the tournament squad by coach Gareth Baber. Ravovo switching at the line with Mothin. Nathangi! They got it away to Nasoko. It's beautiful from Fiji.
And that came from a mistake from South Africa in Fiji. Make them pay. This is an outstanding line. And what was the secret? He hit it at 100 miles an hour. And they are ruthless at the moment, this Fijian team. They are feeling the flow for sure.
Such a strong contingent of Fijian fans behind those posts as well, as Nasoko careered away with Fiji's third try. The conversion is good. The margin is out to 17. Another look at Kalione Nasoko.
Spoke about the vibe in the huddle. This is what they do when they're in that type of mood. They're all running, they're all talking, they're all wanting to get involved in the ball, and that's what he did right there off the scrum.
You know what else? They're all smiling.
Exactly right. No pressure. They're playing their natural football, and look at it. 17-0.
Robot sends this one up the middle. Jussa Vermaelu is on the field. Fiji going in, looking for it. We're going to play that knock-on from South Africa.
Well, this has been the Achilles heel for this Blitz Bok team in this cup final, the kickoff time. Fiji have been outstanding, recognising the mismatches, and Julie taking full toll of them.
Here we go. Team again.
There's another look at the restart. Just so skilled at getting play back in the way. Gets such great hand time on his restarts and enables his crew of 6'6" weapons. That's going to go okay for Fiji. No, it's not. We're coming back to get underneath it. Looking at Fung, he thought he was off again.
Well, if the Blitz Bok are going to have any chance in this game, they need a score from this next piece of play. They need a stable platform. Nails onto the field in jersey number 12, and he's a game breaker in the midfield, big man as well. He's the one that maybe will spark it for South Africa.
Without a number of their frontline players, Justin Heddle, Roscoe Speckman, are they watching on? We're hoping their side can turn their fortunes around in the next 3 minutes. They've got to be the next to score. And with Africa getting in and around the Fiji defence, that may fall their way. Dupria. Great feet, and he's absolutely whacked by Ravogo. Nell on the field. Africa. That one goes a little skew if it is very humid here. And just some perspiration perhaps on the ball, making that a tricky seat to throw.
And this is the difference for me between the two teams. The defence of this Fijian team tonight has been brilliant. They have been bringing the heat, using their shoulders and hitting hard. And that's why they lead 17-0. That's the most surprising thing for me. Be able to keep an offensive unit like South Africa to nil with only 2.5 minutes left is a big thing.
This game has just rattled past.
Send them on, we'll get it.
That game is the highest quality, that's why. Sean Fomai, they put on the show, but Fiji dominating at the physical contact, dominating in the tackle area, dominating position.
Same on.
So just a reminder, Fiji chasing their third straight win here in Hong Kong.
Set.
Looking for their first cup win since this event last year. Through the shots of Ravovo. Ravovo gets in behind. He's struggled for South Africa. Nasoko is up and gone. Nasoko! What a finish! Fiji are fizzing in Hong Kong.
What about the savvy play of Temo Ravovo in jersey number 12. He's the one that gave the last pass. look at him there, using a bit of ball play. The ball away, and as soon as this guy was in open space, Kalione Nasoko gets a double. Oh, yeah.
This is all for show. As we said, that is the epicenter of the Fijian supporter base here at Hong Kong Stadium, and that is not a moment they will ever forget. Conversion's going to come up short, but with a minute to run, it is Fiji up by 22. Can really enjoy themselves now, this Fijian side, over the last minute of play. Revolvo is a man coming from the field. And here comes Veramalur again. So is Wapi. Oh, it's been an area of real concern. The restart for the South Africans. They win the penalty though. Nell spins past the couple. Nell. Gets past a diving Veramalua. Better line this from Davids. Davids. Such a powerful runner. Zane Davids. They give up. Short of the 22. It's all for pride now for the Blitz Bocker, and they will turn it right back to Fiji. Another little knock on, so we might even get a touch more of Fijian magic in the closing stages.
Sydney Gareth maybe just consulting by Tim Wolvo. Looks like he's done an ankle, but what a moment. Beautiful pitches here in Hong Kong.
Ready?
He's been working hard, he's been under pressure, but finally he breaks through and gets his first cup win. And what a time to do it. A place that has so much history for Gareth Baber, Hong Kong.
Set.
A thong it feeds. Back it goes. Kalimisau. Kalimisau. It was comprehensive in every way, shape and form. They have broken a run of outs in the big time games of the HSBC Sevens World Series. This, their first title win since this tournament last year. Three on the bounce on the island of Hong Kong.
What a moment for some of these young players for Fiji, and that just confirms it. Total domination, 22 points to 0 in the cup final.